Hello, everybody. I just want to clarify something real quick. Some people find it hard that I'm running a Pentium 4 and Windows 7 and play Crysis and Call of Duty and Far Cry 2 and all these latest games. Well, some of these aren't latest. Crysis has been out for a while. But nonetheless, playing Crysis on a Pentium 4 is shocking to some people. But just because it's brand new doesn't mean. Just because it's not brand new doesn't mean it can't perform up to standards. And while I'm not able to play Flight Simulator 10 due to its gaming engine being best with at least a Core 2 Duo, that's their gaming engine. They changed the gaming engine in Flight Simulator from more graphics based from 2004 to CPU based in Flight Simulator 10. Expecting people to go out and buy Intel Core 2 Duos or better at the time. But I do have a Pentium 4. It's a Pentium 4 630 at 3 GHz stock speed. It's currently overclocked to just under 3.6 on air cooling. Stock front side bus is 200 MHz overclocked to 238 MHz. And in a game, Starfleet Academy, it's an old game, it's a great game. It's kind of dated graphics-wise for the times. But Captain Kirk tells cadets about ships, where one ship may be brand new and have countless bugs to work out, another ship may be 100 years old, shake like a rattle, and the bugs are long gone, so it works fine. It may, not perform up to new standards, but the bugs in the ship are long gone, so it performs consistently versus a new ship, which has bugs in the system and has problems that have to be worked out, and constant refits and system upgrades and all this stuff. Anyway, to prove that I do have a Pentium 4, I'm going to open Everest. I've got Everest Ultimate Edition. It helps me monitor my CPU temperatures, my GPU temperatures, Windows operating system. It shows the product key for the computer, the everything, but I'm not going to show you the product key. Memory, hard drive, everything. L1, L2 cache. Pentium 4 doesn't have L3 cache. So let's open Everest here. I use it so it's in the common list here in my start menu. Open Everest Ultimate Edition. It loads rather quick. Of course, it may be slowed down due to Camtasia Studio recording. And you can see all the sections here, which is also down here. We're going to go to the motherboard and then click CPU, and you can see Intel Pentium 4 630, 3566 MHz, 15 times 238. So the multiplier's at 15 by 238, which is the overclocked front side bus. And you see it's a Prescott 2M. The instruction set, it has x86 and x64 instruction sets, MMX SSE2, well, SEC and SEC2 and 3. The original clock is 300 MHz. Yeah, 300 MHz. Whew, 3,000 MHz or 3 GHz. Minimum and maximum CPU multiplier 15 times, 14 times, 15 times. L1 trace cache, L2 data cache, L2 cache, 2 MB cache. On die, ECC, ATC, full speed. Motherboard ID, Intel Grantsdale, and it says CPU 1 and 2 due to the hyper-threading. It's instead of two physical CPUs or two physical cores, it has two virtual cores. And this processor is good for multitasking. That's what the hyperthreading in the Pentium 4 was designed for. It's a socket 775. Currently, due to Camtasia Studio, CPU usage is rather high. When Camtasia Studio is not running, CPU usage is very low. And it's got some of the wattages, typical power, maximum power. Running maximum full load, it draws at least 101 watts at 3 gigahertz. And I have all kinds of other stuff, chipset, CPU ID, all the things that my CPU supports, and the 64-bit and 86 or 32-bit x86, x64 memory. Due to motherboard limitations, I can only read up to 3 gigabytes. I have 4 gigabytes of memory, but only 3 gigabytes can be utilized from the motherboard. And so, currently 33% of the physical memory is being used, 18% swap space is being used, 23% virtual memory is being used, page filing is 3%, physical address extension supported by the operating system CPU, and it is active. And it goes through and tells you all the memory, the refresh rate, all this stuff. And you go through the operating system. So, system drivers, services, all the DLL files, all of them. Yep, as soon as the list is going to get very long. And all the stuff, server display, GeForce 9400 GT, 1 gigabyte, driver providers, NVIDIA, of course. But yes, I do have an Intel Pentium 4, 4 gigabytes of RAM, 9400 GT, 1 gigabyte drive. So yes, and I can play Crysis. You can find videos on my channel. The only thing I currently can't do right now is play Flight Simulator 10 like other people. But as soon as I get my new computer up that has a quad 6600, hopefully I can play Flight Simulator 10 if I can get around to getting it. So yeah, I do run a Pentium 4, Windows 7, 4 gigabytes. New doesn't always mean better. Pentium 4 works for me just fine. Soon to be a quad core, and I'll probably keep that for a while. You can enjoy go getting your brand new i7, which I know some people say Flight Simulator 10 doesn't perform as well even on a quad core as it does a Core 2 Duo. So, yeah.